It was snug on him anyway, she said. His wife, my stepmother, when she offered it like a monthly magazine already read. Nothing she would miss if I took it. Something to keep me warm in the bitter afternoon of late March. To turn my thoughts from the empty bed where she said he had lain for a week. She hadn't phoned. She kept believing he'd recovered, that he'd guide her down the hospital corridor to their car as he'd done before. My sleek father, who kept slipping into childhood. My brilliant daddy, with only saliva on his tongue. How the worn wool glowed, how its burgundy twill warmed me, as if it were the wine, the same name, and I had my fill. I folded the sleeves at the wrist, pushed them up like small accordions. All the way home on the plane, I lay back in my window seat, surrounded by the sad comfort of his familiar redolence. 10 years later, I'm astounded. I never wore it again. Not once have I lifted it from the closet shelf where it lies, in the pungence of cedar, out of sight, like the soldier my father had been in the forests of Germany, the Chargeau of France, where he had hidden his fear like a stolen radio. Its voice is foreign but alive, indecipherable and distant, as now his own voice has grown. Inscrutable as faith, insistent as the long absence of his breath.